Hi guys, welcome to Learning Mathematics with Prep Class. I am BC, I am a Prep Class tutor. In this video, we are going to be solving Loyola Jesuit College Entrance Examination Mathematics Paper 2 from question 41 to question 45. Subscribe to our channel, like and make comments on our videos, and then you can also join us on WhatsApp by clicking on the link in the description below. The first question in this video, question 41. If 42 pairs cost 725 naira, what is the cost of 2,175 pairs? Wow, this is very interesting. Okay, so let's get out the information from this question. Let's start with the first sentence. If 42 pairs cost 725 naira, so the cost of 42 pairs is 725 naira. What is the cost of 2,175 pairs? So we are asked to find the cost of 2,175 pairs. So for us to be able to find the cost of 2,175 pairs, we need to find out the cost of one pair, and then we multiply it by 2,175 to get the cost of 2,175 pairs. Okay, so what is the cost of one pair? So the cost of 42 pairs is 725 naira. So just one pair would cost 725 naira divided by 42. That is it here. So that is the cost of one pair. Now, remember, I told you that to now find the cost of 2,175 pairs, we multiply the cost of one pair by 2,175 pairs. So the cost of one pair is 725 naira divided by 42 multiplied by 2,175. Okay, so since this is a fraction, we can also divide this by 1. Okay, so 725 times 2,175 divided by 42 times 1. So we have 725 naira multiplied by 2,175 divided by 42. Now, let's continue. So, what is 725 naira multiplied by 2,175? You can pause this video, do your calculation, and then see if you got the correct answer. So, 725 naira multiplied by 2,175 is 1,576,875 naira. Divided by 42. 1,576,875 divided by 42 is 37,544 naira 64 kobo. So the cost of 2,175 pairs is 37,544 naira 64 kobo. Now, which of the options is correct? Is it A, 38,324 naira 64 kobo? No. B, 38,269 naira 64 kobo? No. C, 38,504 naira 64 kobo? No. D, 37,544 naira 64 kobo? Yes, this is the correct option. D is the correct answer for question 41. Okay, let's move on to the next question, question 42. Express 2,882 as a Roman numeral. Okay, how do we do this? This is very easy. Okay, so in Roman numerals, M is 1,000, D is 500, C is 100, L is 50, X is 10, V is 5, I is 1. Now let's break down 2,822 to 2,000 plus 800 plus 20 plus 2. So we can break down this number into chunks. So we have 2,000 plus 800 plus 20 plus 2. Now let's find out what each of these mean in Roman numeral. So 2,000 is 1,000 plus 1,000, right? And 1,000 in Roman numeral is M. I hope you remember that. It's right here. Okay, so 1,000 and 1,000, that would be MM. That's 2,000. okay? Then 800, if we break down 800, we can have 500 plus 100 plus 100 plus 100. 500 is D in Roman numerals. 100 is C. 100 is C and 100 is C. So 500 plus 100 plus 100 plus 100 will give us 800. So we have it in Roman numerals as D, C, C, C. Then 20 is 10 plus 10. X is 10 in Roman numerals. So 20 would be XX. Then 2 is 1 plus 1. I is 1 in Roman numerals. So 2 is going to be II. So let's add this together now. MM plus DCCC plus XX plus II would have MM DCCC XXII. So 2822 written as a Roman numeral is MM DCCC XXII. As simple as ABC. Okay, which of the option is correct? A is the correct option. MM DCCC XXII. That is the correct option. Okay, question 43. Simplify 12 times 5 plus 53. So, when we have more than one operation in a question, we use the Bodman's rule on order of operation. So, when we want to do a question with different kinds of operation, we don't just do it anyhow. We follow a rule called Bodman's. What does Bodman's mean? Bracket, off, division, multiplication, addition, subtraction. So this means that you should do the operation in bracket first, then you do the operation with off. Off means multiplication. So you just change the off to multiplication sign. Then you do the division, multiplication, addition, and subtraction. So this is the order of operation in mathematics. Now let's use this Bodman's rule to solve this question. Remember, the multiplication comes before addition. We have multiplication and addition in this question. So according to the rule of Bodman's, multiplication comes first before addition. So we'll do the multiplication first. So that is 12 times 5. Let's do 12 times 5 here. 5 times 2 is 10. So write 0, carry 1. 5 times 1 is 5. 5 plus 1 is 6. So 12 times 5 is 60. So we've been able to do that. Now, let's do the addition. So we now have 60 plus 53 now. Let's do that here. 60 plus 53. 0 plus 3 is 3. 6 plus 5 is 11. So the answer is 113. Therefore, 12 times 5 plus 53 equals 113. As simple as ABC. Now, which of the option is correct? Option A is the correct option because that is the answer, 113. 12 times 5 plus 53 is 113. Now, let's move on to question 44. Evaluate 15 for ninth plus 22 third plus 24 for ninth. Now, many people think that fractions are very difficult. No, fractions are very easy to solve. Once you already know how to do it, it becomes easy for you. Now, let's learn how to add these fractions. So, what kind of fractions are these? They are mixed fractions. This is because they have the whole number part and the fraction part. Some fractions are just the usual fractions, like the proper or improper fractions. They do not have the whole number part. But these are mixed fractions. They have both the whole number part and the fraction part. So let's express these mixed fractions as whole number and fractions. So 15 for ninth is the same thing as writing 15 plus 4 ninth plus 20 plus 2 third plus 24 plus 4 ninth. So we can express this mixed fraction like this. So 15 here is the whole number, 4 over 9 is the fraction, 20 is the whole number, 2 third is the fraction, 24 is the whole number, 4 ninth is the fraction. Okay, now we separate the whole numbers from the fractions. So we write the whole numbers 15 plus 20 plus 24 plus the fractions part. 4 over 9 plus 2 over 3 plus 4 over 9, right? Now, 15 plus 20 plus 24. Let's do that here. 5 plus 0 is 5. 5 plus 4 is 9. 1 plus 2 is 3. 3 plus 2 is 5. So the answer is 59. So 59 plus 4 over 9 plus 2 third plus 4 ninths, right? So, but we cannot add these fractions part yet. Why? Because they are unlike fractions. What are unlike fractions? Unlike fractions are fractions that have different denominators. They do not have the same denominators. For you to be able to add fractions, they have to be like fractions. Okay? But these are unlike fractions. So we have to convert them to like fractions. How do we do this? We can convert unlike fractions to like fractions by simply finding a common denominator. And this common denominator can be found by obtaining the LCM of the denominators. What is LCM? LCM means lowest common multiple. How can we find the LCM of these denominators? We can use the prime factorization method. The first step in using the prime factorization method is to express the denominators, that is 9, 3, and 9, as a product of their prime factors. The denominators are the bottom numbers of the fraction. I hope you know that. So let's express 9, 3, and 9 as a product of their prime factors. What are prime factors? Prime factors are the prime numbers you multiply together to make a number. Okay, so the prime factors of a number are the numbers that you can multiply together to make that number. Okay, so 9 is equal to 1 times 3 times 3. If you multiply these numbers, you will have 9. And these numbers are all prime numbers. That is, they can only be divisible by 1 and itself. 3, written as a product of its prime factors, is 1 times 3. 9 is 1 times 3 times 3. Now, the next step is to multiply the prime factors. But the common factors are included once. You include the common factors just once. So now, 1 is common to all of them, so we write it once. 3 is common to all of them, we write it once. 3 is also common, so we have it as 1 times 3 times 3, which is 9. So the LCM of 9, 3, and 9 is 9. Now that we have found the LCM, we can now convert the denominators of each fraction to the LCM. That is, each fraction should have a denominator of 9. How do we do this? We can do this by multiplying the denominators by a number that would give the same as the LCM, and also multiply the numerator by the same number. So, 4 over 9. So, we want this to have a denominator of 9. So, this already has a denominator of 9. So, we can just say, let's multiply by 1. So, 4 times 1 is 4. 9 times 1 is 9. Then the next fraction is 2 over 3. So we want to convert this denominator to 9. So what do we multiply by 3 to get 9? 3 multiplied by 3 is 9. So we do the same thing to the numerator as well. We multiply the numerator by 3. So 2 times 3 is 6. 3 times 3 is 9. So we have 6 over 9. Then the next fraction is 4 over 9. So this already has the same denominator as the LCM. Okay, so let's multiply by 1. 9 times 1 is 9. 4 times 1 is 4. So the answer is 4 over 9. So this means that 4 over 9 plus 2 over 3 plus 4 over 9 is now 4 over 9 plus 6 over 9 plus 4 over 9. I hope you're following. Now the next step is to add the numerators and divide by the common denominator. Can you see now that they are like fractions? Remember, we're trying to convert them to like fractions. Now, all these fractions have the same denominator, so we can go ahead and add them now. So we add the numerators and divide by the common denominator. So 4 plus 6 plus 4 divided by 9. 4 plus 6 is 10. 10 plus 4 is 14. So we have 14 over 9. Now we have gotten the answer. But the options are all mixed fractions. So this means that we have to convert 14 over 9 to mixed fraction. How can we do this? This can be done by dividing the numerator by the denominator. Then you write as quotient, remainder divided by denominator. Let's do that now. 14 divided by 9. is 1. 9 times 1 is 9. 14 minus 9 is 5. So the quotient is 1, the remainder is 5. So this means that 14 over 9 converted to mixed fraction is now one whole number 5 over 9. Now we are not sure. Remember, we still have the whole number part. And when we did it, we add 59 plus 4 over 9 plus 2 third plus 4 ninth, right? So now we've been able to evaluate 4 over 9 plus 2 over 3 plus 4 over 9 to give us one whole number 5 over 9. So we add it to the whole number part, which is 59. So let's add the whole number part. So we have 59 plus 1 plus 5 over 9. 59 plus 1 is 60 plus 5 over 9. And this can be written together again as 65 over 9. 60 whole number, 5 over 9. So we've been able to solve this question completely now. So the answer is 60 whole number, 5 over 9. So the correct option is B, 60 whole number, 5 over 9. So the last question in this video, question 45. Express 76 ratio 14 in its lowest ratio. What is ratio? Ratio compares value. So in ratio, you compare one thing with another thing. To solve a ratio problem, express in the lowest term by dividing by the common factors. So ratio can be expressed as division, right? So 76 ratio 14, this colon is ratio. That's the symbol for ratio. So 76 ratio 14 can be expressed as 76 divided by 14. Now let's divide 76 and 14 by their common factors. 2 can divide 76 and can also divide 14. So 76 divided by 2 is 38. 14 divided by 2 is 7. So we have 38 divided by 7 now. Can we still simplify this to a lower term? No, because 38 and 7 do not have any common factors again. So that means that we've been able to express it in the lowest term already. Now, division can also be expressed as ratio. So let's write 38 divided by 7 as 38 ratio 7. So 76 ratio 14 in its lowest ratio is 38 ratio 7. As simple as that. All you have to do is to reduce to its lowest term. That's all. Now, which of the options is correct? B is the correct option. 38 ratio 7. Check. I hope you enjoyed this video and you're able to learn a lot from it. Don't forget to like and comment on this video. Subscribe to our channel. Join us on WhatsApp by clicking on the link in the description below. Till I come your way next time. Bye.